Good evening. There's a nervous stalemate holding across Russia tonight with an influential military leader in exile after what looked like a coup attempt on the Kremlin was called off at the last minute. Paid mercenaries who were meant to be fighting for Vladimir Putin in Ukraine marched into Russia and within 200 kilometres of Moscow before turning back. Only an 11th-hour deal with their leader avoided a brutal conflict. But the political blow has left the Russian president looking weak in the face of an uprising of his own making.
In Russia's port city of Rostov-on-Don, celebrations. After being overrun and occupied, the private, mercenary Wagner army were now packing up and heading out. It was over as quickly as it had begun, less than 24 hours, but the ramifications will likely rewrite Russia's history. The man at the centre of it all, Yevgeny Prigozhin, also on the move, exiled to neighbouring Belarus after shaking the foundations of the Putin presidency.
This is an enormous shock to Russian politics. An enormous shock to President Putin's regime.
Prigozhin, a longtime critic of Russian defence leaders, had blamed them for a lethal attack on one of his bases on Friday. He instantly launched 25,000 troops, tanks, armour in rapid deployment for Moscow. The Russians started digging up roads to slow the convoy and even blew up its own fuel depots to stop them refuelling. Wagner forces seen in counter-attack here, a missile narrowly missing this Russian helicopter. It sparked panic and chaos for civilians in Rostov, railway stations packed with people trying to flee. Within hours, Prigozhin had taken control of the town.
It's 7:30. Rostov's military sites are under the control of Wagner fighters.
Prigozhin's troops had moved with lightning speed from the Ukraine front line into Russia, straight through Rostov and north, reaching just 200 kilometres from Moscow's centre. But then, the sudden order to stop.
We're turning back our columns and returning to our field camps.
A peace reportedly broken by the Belarusian president.
It's the most dramatic military political confrontation in Russia in the last 30 years.
So, who is Yevgeny Prigozhin? A gangster, war criminal and billionaire. A one-time teen criminal who served 9 years on theft offences, got out and started a hot dog business, which he grew into a chain of restaurants that made him a fortune. He won the Kremlin's catering contract, earned the nickname of Putin's chef, but over time he learned to cater to the president's other needs.
He started a secret private army, the Wagner Group, in Ukraine in 2014 and quickly gained a fearsome reputation for brutality. Expanding to Syria and Africa, where they were paid in gold and blood diamonds.
Often illegal and definitely grubby.
Wagner's total force size, 50,000 worldwide, and up to 80% of them have been recruited from prison. He also took to cyber warfare on the US presidential elections, but his move on Russia's president will be all but impossible to come back from.
Putin has cleared him of charges, but experts say he will not forgive or forget.
If you're Yevgeny Prigozhin, you need to get a new food taster and, you know, watch your back.
And Chris Reason joins me now. Chris, what does this coup attempt mean for Russia's war in Ukraine?
Well, Ukraine, Mark, is possibly the only beneficiary in this short-lived rebellion. Russia has had to move its military focus from the front lines to the home front, while the Wagner army is now leaderless and uncertain of its future. In short, it is a mess. Great for Ukraine. The bigger question now, though, is Putin's future. This may not have threatened his life, but his political life is now in jeopardy, and it throws nuclear-armed Russia into the worst domestic turmoil it has faced in decades. Putin's decision to invade Ukraine last year, Mark, really has spectacularly backfired.
It sure has. Chris Reason, thank you. Let's go to our US correspondent Tim Lester in Washington, D.C. now. Tim, this military action had world leaders on edge for some time.
Mark, certainly here in Washington, they've known about it for a while. Apparently, US intelligence picked up the first signs of the rebellion almost 2 weeks ago, they briefed the White House behind me, but also the State Department, the Pentagon, and senior figures in the US Congress. So all of them, including President Biden, wouldn't have been surprised as they watched the events of the last couple of days unfold. They were deeply worried, though, the president in particular, by the thought that he might face a situation where he didn't know who was in charge of Russia's nuclear arsenal. That hasn't come to pass this time, but Vladimir Putin, the Russian president, significantly weakened by the events of the last few days. US intelligence likely now is out trying to find where the Russian leader's next threat is coming from. Mark.
Okay, Tim Lester with the latest from Washington.